The medical profession is one that people generally claim to admire and respect. Many persons desire to become medical doctors, or if they can't, they do everything in their power to ensure that their own children become doctors. Anyone that becomes one is usually envied by his peers or parents whose children have not been able to become doctors. First and foremost, reading medicine is made so difficult with the requirements in school certificates requirements, JAM score and the horrible exams with the out of this world pass mark that is not fixed in medical school. Those who have seen medical students or lived with them in school consider them as unusual breeds. When they eventually graduate, everyone envy them because of the guaranteed first paid job called housemanship and subsequent locum job usually called PP in private clinics. Because they were few, they used to get job placements easily. Now a lot of that has changed in Nigeria. Doctors walk for months, a year or more, looking for a placement for house job. When they get one, some may not be paid for 9 months until they demonstrate and carry placards before they are paid. There are several unemployed doctors in their homes now. There is even a suggestion that they should not be paid during the housemanship. When the doctor starts working, everyone feel that the doctors are comfortable and highly priced spouse material. For the men, the money they have to pay for bride price is something else, because there is that unvoiced assumption that the doctor is rich. Everyone wants to extract his own pound, sterling from him, her. In family gatherings, they are disproportionately tasked to pay more. When they have personal problems, nobody considers to assist them because the people believe that he can always afford to solve his problems by himself. When another person is in need, the doctor is one of the first persons that they run to for help. In churches, the doctor is always sought after to handle the medical and health issues of church members. He is most often expected to bring the medical consumables and bring his expertise and enlist the expertise of his colleagues to sponsor the health outreaches of the church. When the prophets and pastors are praying and declaring blessings on their members, one major area of emphasis is, "No doctor will eat your money this year in Jesus' name," and you will hear a resounding amen. "You will not waste your money in hospital for anything in Jesus' name," amen. When these prophets have cursed the businesses of these DRS, they invite them to contribute heavily and sow seeds in the kingdom. Where will the doctor make this money from to do these expectations? At the end of the year, one major point of testimonies in churches and conventions is that, throughout the year, no doctor ate their money. They see patronizing the doctor as sowing into leaking pockets. When those who know you have need for money, you are one of the best options to assist. When they are not feeling well, they call you and expect you to prescribe medicines for free for them. Some even feel you should prescribe and provide money to buy medicines for them if they are close to you. If as a doctor you are broke and you ask for loan, they will laugh and say, "Are you mocking me?" They will hardly believe you and won't give you. If you have 9 other siblings and you are the only doctor or nurse and your parents are alive, the health burden of your parents lies with you. They are most likely to live in your house so that you can take care of them. Most of your siblings won't even support you financially for that responsibility. Before now, when you tell police or other law enforcement agents that you are a doctor, it paves the way for you to pass. These days, when you tell a policeman that you are a doctor, that's when your own rojo will increase to match up with your status. The hawker sells things to you at higher price. The artisans that work for you charge more money, but when they are ill, it's you they will call for free consultation. They don't go and collect the drug free from the pharmacists. Anybody with these multi-level marketing business sees the doctor as that person that can help push his products, and they struggle to recruit you into their scheme. The politicians make the public feel that health is paramount, and when they want to deceive the electorate with their lies and electoral promises, they will call doctors to organize health outreach. They make healthcare free without providing the necessary things to sincerely make healthcare free. When the doctor can't provide what the government promised, the doctor is blamed for stealing all the drugs in the hospital. Electorate now feel that the doctors are stealing government money and medications. They become soft targets for the people who seek healthcare services. When the politicians and influential members of the public become critically ill and saved by the doctors, they will come out praising them and promise to fund the health sector, a promise they never fulfill. The doctor takes the bashing when a Congolese person is rushed to the hospital and he demands that they pay for services. Everyone shouts, "Save life first before talking about money." When the doctor does so and patient gets well, all the people shouting that you save life first disappear and nobody pays your bill. One even ask, "When this child survive, you can send her on errand, so why insisting on money being paid?" When the money is much like in surgery and other highly demanding medical care, and the doctor refused to let go of his money and insists that the patient pays bill complete before leaving hospital, it's then you will know that the patients have family lawyer and NGOs who could not raise money to pay his bills, and media to paint the doctor bad and blackmail him to let the patient go without paying bill. Some even arrest the doctor, close down the hospital and seek that the doctor's license be seized for keeping a patient in hospital for not paying bill. Society collapses for this step by the patient and relatives. Some patients will run away from hospital without payments. Most people will be quick to say that your calling is a humanitarian job, so if you know you can't do it, why go into it? It's your choice, so just do it. And I ask, are there humanitarian schools for our children to attend? Humanitarian cars we can buy? Are there humanitarian houses or building materials or furniture that we can patronize at affordable prices? Society will be quick to tell you, it was your choice to become a doctor and so you should not complain. Really? So if it's your choice to become a banker, you may give loan and the beneficiary may not pay you back, but you should continue to work since it was your choice? Most of these unfair treatments, doctors are managing to put up with quietly, but the worst happens when something goes wrong while the doctor renders his job. The doctor is expected by society to be perfect and almost be God himself. Even when a patient has died and they had taken to church to pray for hours, they come back to hospital that the man of God said the doctor should just give oxygen and that the patient will live again. And if you don't oblige them, you will see the bad side of believers. When doctors make the sacrifice to save their patients, no one remembers, they feel it's just the doctor's responsibility. A doctor saw a child gasping for breath because there was no blood in the body. He quickly set a line, gave oxygen, went to the blood bank, offered himself to donate blood, brought the blood and transfused the patient, and the child is living today. The doctor is not applauded for heroism. And it looked normal. These days when Nigerians' eyes are opening and the lawyers are awake to punish the doctors for negligence, you see that everyone hates the doctor with a passion. Once an issue about negligence shows up in the social media, you will see everybody asking that the doctor pays for everything they claim went wrong. He should be stripped of his practicing license, sent to jail, and his hospital closed. The impact of these actions on numerous families is not considered. This is not to condone negligence or malpractice, but I am a bit worried about the vehemence with which this is pursued and the outpouring of bitterness by the general public. Nobody is interested in hearing the doctor's angle, and by his training and code of practice he can't come out and counter what the patient claim in public. They always believe that these doctors, their own is too much and they should pay in full for all the monies that they have been collecting from people for treating them. The highest fines are prescribed for the doctor. The hypocrisy is just too much when they say that life is too precious to be toyed with. That is why the doctor must receive maximum punishment. Let's agree that life is so precious, and so everyone that takes life or does anything that takes or threatens life should receive maximum punishment. What about the investor that starts something called MBA, Forex, MMM and other Ponzi schemes that defraud people and many people die as a consequence? What punishment is given to him? When an engineer supervises work on a project and the building collapses and several lives are lost, as it happened 2-3 years ago in PH and several places in Nigeria, what has been done to the engineer or architect? They still have their license to practice and they are still practicing. They are walking around and some are still holding their offices. People just see it as an accident. What happens to a lawyer who, out of greed or negligence, a client suffers or is even sentenced to death or to life in prison for a time he didn't commit? Does he have his license withdrawn? Is he publicly disgraced? Is there anything like legal negligence? What about the tanker drivers and petroleum marketers who, though their activities' lives get lost through fires or explosions, those filling stations still have their licenses to do business? Is there anything like driving negligence or business negligence? Some media persons carry unconfirmed reports on air or in social media. Persons may die in the process, and yet the person is still practicing. Is the media ethical negligence? They may fine the media house but license not withdrawn. The law enforcement officers have caused the death of several persons and they don't get fired. Is the no security negligence? The politicians during elections using armed officers cause so many deaths and nothing happens thereafter. The wrong judgment of our politicians results in deaths of so many people in the country, and yet there is no offense as political negligence. If there is an offense as political negligence, an absentee president should be sued for negligence. Some pastors and prophets instruct their members not to go to hospital because they will deliver as Hebrew women, and some not to accept surgeries and other medical interventions. The patients die and nobody accuses the prophet for religious negligence. Rather, they say it's the will of God. The businessman, woman imports medical equipment and medicines that are substandard and it fails to serve the doctor in rendering services to the patient. The doctor is charged for medical negligence, while the importer is not charged for business negligence. It is so unfortunate that when judges and lawyers commit any wrongdoing, they are tried in secret. You only hear the outcome when the person is removed from office. None is prosecuted for judicial negligence. The other professions don't even do any trial, whether open or secret. It is only the doctors that their trial for misconduct, the almighty medical negligence, is aired on national TV. This is after being judged and destroyed by the court of public opinion on social media. It's so sad. It feels so bad to be a doctor at this time. Can society just try and hold everyone and every trade accountable for negligence and not just the doctors? Can they be given the benefit of doubt by hearing their own side of the story before we jump into judgment and condemnation? If you are a doctor, be diligent, document all your actions and communicate all your thoughts. Don't ever be deceived into believing that any person admires you for what you do. Just know that they envy you for what you do but are helpless to vent their venom on you so long as things turn out right for the patient and your pocket reaches out to them. See yourselves as sheep in the midst of wolves. Develop lawful survival strategies. May God protect the